we didn't have many kids channels. Probably Uttam is here, and Uttam was at Turner at that time. And probably there were three. Cartoon Network was there, maybe Disney, and just two or three channels. And the channels that existed were pretty much showing foreign content. Yeah. So mainly it used to be Tom and Jerry, American shows, or Japanese shows. There wasn't any Indian content or very little Indian content. And for us, or the Indian animation industry, to knock the doors of these channels and say we want to do something, develop original Indian content, it was very difficult, very, very difficult. And luckily, thanks to Pogo, we had our bunch of initial shows that started. We started with Vikram Betal, and then we had Krishna series, and then even for us to get Chota Bheem on air, it took us almost 3 years of knocking the doors, and very, very difficult for at that time. But once Chota Bheem went on air, and Pogo started to rate number one for bunch of years, and the character and the show went on to become really big and, you know, recognized all over India, all over world. So that's when I think the Indian animation kind of took off, and there were far more people willing to do original shows, original IPs, create Indian content. And you know, my friend from Maya is here. Then they went on to do Motu Patlu again. This was a game changer in a way, because till then all the animation shows were all 2D animation, and this was the first 3D show, and that took off, and so on. And now today, if you see the animation industry and the broadcasters, the kids channels, probably 25 kids channels are there. So there is a lot of market that is there for the original IP and original content. So I think given that there is so much opportunity, this is really a golden period for animation and content creators, especially the IP creators. Because on one side, you have all these broadcasters that are looking for new content, 20-25 channels. And to add to that, there is a market of theatrical movies, feature films, animated feature films. I'll come to that in a little bit. And then there is also a market for OTT. So if you see, there's Amazon, Voot, Netflix, Balaji, the list keeps going. And so there is far more original content in animation coming on these OTT players as well. So as the industry is growing and as the market is growing, so there's a lot more room for Indian animation, because something that you put on Amazon or Netflix goes immediately global. And so when we signed up recently, our first show with Amazon called Kalari Kids, it's already on air. And then we signed up Mighty Little Bheem with Netflix. So when it goes on air, it goes to 190 countries. So the Indian animation goes worldwide, and there again creates a market for ourselves. So it's a very good golden period for us, and we guys need to deliver good content, good quality, and on time. These are must-haves when you work with big broadcasters, and do that. You develop a good IP, then there is again an entire domain where you can get more revenues for your company. either through licensing of your characters or merchandising of the characters, gaming, events, AR, VR, and so on. So once you have it, you know, the sky is the limit to exploit it. And going international, we ourselves didn't know when we had Chota Bhim that it will succeed outside India. The dhoti wearing guy, how will he work somewhere? And in Indonesia, it's the third biggest show. And that's again pretty surprising for ourselves. But you never know what will work as long as you don't keep trying. And you make good content, you are likely to succeed. Now, coming to the Indian feature films, from animation standpoint, there hasn't much animated movies that came out. There are probably a handful. And none of them, I think barring one or two, none of them crossed even 10 crore. So it's a very tricky thing because in India, the animation movies are perceived, ye bachon ka movie hai or for kids. So if you go to a theater, you'll see a row of 20 kids, one mother in that corner and one maid in this corner. So that is potentially 75 tickets, right? If both the parents show up. And that is something we are all working to break the barrier that animation movies are not just for kids. I mean, something like a Frozen or a Moana, I mean, families go out and watch. So there's a lot of effort. It's the industry itself. We need to push that barrier. We need to create those great movies. And then the market is there. You see the movies that are earning hundreds of crores. I mean, even if one third of that animation movie earns, it will be great. I think it's a great period for the animation industry. There is huge potential. A lot of innovation can be done. The Indian storytelling is quite good. Again, when you try to go out into the world, it need not be, you have to be westernized or have a story. If you see, Moana was not really a western story, right? So you could take an Indian story or different stories and make them global. As long as the quality is good, the music is good, and you deliver a good product, it will work. So to wrap up, I will play a couple of trailers. I was just talking about breaking the barrier for animated movies. We are coming with two movies this summer, and one in summer and one we are yet to decide the date. The first movie is a mythology movie. It's based on Hanuman. It's called Mairavan, which will release in summer. And the second movie is Chota Bhim. Obviously, we release Chota Bhim movie every year. It's called Kung Fu Dhamaka, which the date is not yet decided. So I'll close my speech.